Section 45Q tells us that the taxpayer that owns the carbon capture equipment and either physically or contractually ensures the capture, disposal, use, or utilization of that carbon dioxide is entitled to the credit. Well, what does it mean to contractually ensure any of that activity? It means that you've entered into a binding contract with the other party enforceable under state law that does not limit damages to any specified amount. But merely entering into a binding contract with another party does not entitle that party to any of the credits. Instead, the taxpayer that owns the carbon capture equipment that is entitled to the credit has the right to elect under the code on an annual basis to allow those taxpayers that dispose, utilize, or use as an ejected the carbon oxide to claim all or part of the credit. The proposed regulations issued in the end of May expand upon this, and they're fairly generous. They allow the transfer of credits to multiple parties. It allows the transfers to be made in whole or part, but it limits the credits transferred to what would be proportional. So if a taxpayer owns carbon capture equipment and it contracts with two other taxpayers to provide storage services, each for 50% of the carbon dioxide that is captured, the limit on the allocation of election to transfer credits to either party would be 50%.